So today I have the pleasure of meeting Eddie Kilty, head chef of the Inn on the Lake, on Ullswater in the Lake District. Fantastic to meet you, Eddie.
Yeah, nice to meet you too.
How are you today?
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, very good.
So if you could just give us an update on why we're here today.
It just relates back to February when I came across Visionary Dining and I signed up to the website and I'm just posted basically a few pictures of what I was doing, my style of food, and just to see what other chefs in the industry were doing as well, just to keep everyone updated sort of thing. I was contacted by the Visionary Dining team at the end of the month to say that that they'd pick me to be the dish of the month, which would be forwarded on to an awards evening in November. They said like my food was elegant and, you know, simplicity and stuff like that, and that was quite a nice achievement, and I was quite happy about that. The owners of the hotel as well, they were very, very happy, more than happy in fact. And yeah, just been pushing things on since then really. It's been a long, hard 8 months, and it's going to get better hopefully. At the end of the year it's going to be good.
Well, you know, throughout this short film we're going to be showcasing some of the dishes that we've had the pleasure of tasting today. What was really, I mean, as you know, we've got hundreds of chefs uploading these photographs and competition is tough, but what really came across from your food is that it looked really emotional. It looked as if there was a chef expressing himself, not just going through technique for technique's sake. It was wonderfully seasonal, and although you can't eat a photograph, we certainly came close to it. And I think you are very good at presenting low to medium cost food in a very exciting way that provides high value to the customer. And in terms of our agenda, that's really important for the industry to see. So well done on that. There's only 12 chefs who are going to be honoured in this way this year. So big well done. If you could just sort of give us an overview of your career and where you think your career is going and where you see the vision of your cooking kicking in along the way.
My career when I started off, it was very, you know, it was up and down. When I started off, I was quite lucky because I won an apprenticeship with the Whitbread company, which is part of like Marriott chain. It was a school competition at the time, Junior MasterChef Challenge. And it began there really, my love for cooking really. Just, you know, it wasn't my first thing I wanted to be, a chef, you know, and I won the competition, which went through the stages of like menu development, planning and cook-offs and stuff like that. It was competing against like, I think it was 12 other schools at the time. So I ended up winning it, got offered an apprenticeship with the Whitbreads, went to college one day a week, done my MVQ level 1-2, and it was very good. I enjoyed it, and then I got sort of headhunted after that sort of thing by other restaurants in Liverpool. I've worked for quite a few good chefs in my time, sort of picked up a lot of different styles of food, from fine dining and bistro to Italian, Spanish. You know, I like to think all my food that I do now is sort of goes back to that, what I've learned over the years, and it's become my own style, which I quite enjoy because I like the whole simplicity of, you know, not overcomplicating but keeping it, you know, within a nice price range and you know, something that people can necessarily do at home as well, you know, and like, you know, that's the I like that style. It's very like homely, you know.
So you sort of keep to comfort flavours and like predictable flavours. So you're not challenging the diner.
No, well, yeah, sometimes we do, but I like to develop it into like a modern technique of cooking. We do use our Ultratex, you know, and we use our tapioca multidoxin and stuff like that to make like horseradish snow, and you know, and just taking something that's like old fashioned and making it modern. And that's what I like doing. You know, I think sometimes you can overcomplicate things and it just doesn't work.
Okay. You know? If what you cook is an extension of your personality, how would you describe you and therefore your food?
I'd like to say I'm open-minded, you know. I'm not afraid to try things, and I think most people should be like that, because, you know, when you're a chef, you've got to be very open-minded of what you've got to take into consideration about, you know, your different clientele's, you know, and, you know, how can you cater for all of them, and, you know, how can you make it work. So I like to think, like, you know, I'm quite a chilled person, so I'm mellow in the kitchen. I'm not like a, you know, I'm not going to shout at you and stuff like that for no reason, you know, unless I've got, you know, obviously a reason to. But yeah, my personality reflects on my food for sure. Like, it's, you know, it's fun, it's clean, it's simple, elegant, seasonal, you know, and obviously, you know, fresh. And that's what I like, that's what I enjoy doing. And it's had a major impact in the hotel. Hi, this is Eddie Kilty. I've chosen to do my take on a Waldorf salad today. We've taken it into a bit more modern way of cooking. We've made a nice potato and goat cheese pressing. And we've set it overnight in the fridge and then just finished it off pan frying it to get a bit of colour and heat through it. And then what we've done is with the salad garnish, we've took in it, pickled the shallots, red wine, made some candied walnuts, on the mandolin, mandolin the celery, blanched it in water, salted water, and then cooled it down in the ice bath to keep it nice and fresh and green. And then we pickled some grapes.
What we also liked about your food, even more once we began to investigate you and get our feel for what you do, is that this is a fairly chunky hotel here.
Yeah.
And you're a hotel chef.
Yeah.
You're not a high street restaurant chef here. You've got all these other things going on, and you've got a big team.
Yeah.
And we like the fact that you're finding time to put refinements into a hotel dining room.
Yeah.
A lot of the videos that we do are restaurants within hotels, but you've got to mix all this up. Really.
Yeah.
And that means that you're potentially under more pressure to satisfy more markets. How do you cope with that?
It can be challenging, very challenging. We turn over about 180 weddings a year. You know, we do a busy
heavens pub, above.
A busy pub which does 350 covers on a busy sunny day. I've got the restaurant which can do 40 to 80 covers in a night, and then we've got obviously wedding parties that stay the night before, so they come in big groups. So we try and offer everything that we can, really. And when it comes to the restaurants, I think if people want the option to go and have that a little bit extra, you know, and sit down and be wined and dined, and in a nice dining room and fresh, elegant food, you know, 9 times out of 10 people do, and we get a lot of good feedback off our customers, and we get repeat customers a lot of the year, and you know, there's like always guests asking to see me and to tell me how, you know, nice the food is, and the menus are wonderful, and if there's something on the menu that they want, I'll try and cater for them, you know. Just like to try and be open-minded and not say no to people. It is hard going, but we pull through, and all the lads in the kitchen, they're all pretty much the same as me, you know, pretty open-minded, and, you know, they try and please everyone. I know that sometimes it's a bit impossible, but but we try our best. This is a dish, New England clam chowder, my take on it. Literally what we've done is we've used Scottish local scallops, just simply pan-fried them in a bit of butter. We've made a langoustine stock base and then reduced it with a bit of cream into a nice light soup consistency, more like a velouté. And then we've confit some potatoes in a thyme-infused oil, made a nice smoked pancetta crisp, again using the local clams as well. In the bit of stock base, and then just brunoise some vegetables down, and then just finished it off with some nice thyme cress, a few drops of white truffle oil, just to get a nice, clean, fresh, elegant look.
As a chef, what influences you? What resources do you access?
I do a lot of internet-based research, Michelin star chefs, a lot of food, like websites like Visionary Dine and Staff Canteen, and just like, you know, the GreatBritishChef.com and stuff like that. I watch a lot of TV programs like Great British Menu and MasterChef. So I like to watch it and research it, just simply because I like to continue to learn and pick up new styles and techniques. You know, it can just take one little thing, and you know, you go, oh, I could do that in my restaurant, or you know, I could do that on my menu. And I eat out quite a lot as well in different restaurants around the area, so that, you know, I like to broaden my mind. You know,
this is the my modern take on coq au vin. It's a dish that I've been working on for a couple of years, just redeveloping different ideas and styles. What we've done is today we've used a local corn-fed chicken breast. We've rolled it, and then we've slightly part steamed it, just keep it moist, and then just finished off in the oven just to get the skin crispy. And then we've got it sat on a Maxim potato, which has been cooked in butter stock in the oven. And then what we've done is, to be a bit different, we've confit chicken legs down, picked it, and then put them into a bonbon to make it, and then kept the bone, cleaned the bone up, and paneed it, deep fry it, to make it into like a chicken leg lollipop, and it sat on a wild mushroom.
Sounds. So if I gave you £500 now to go dine anywhere, where would you go?
I'd go to Longclume. I'd go to Samlin. I'd go to Ramsbeck, just down the road. Go down to London, and go to Marcus Wearing's, you know, Gordon Ramsay's, Eston Blumenthal as well. I think he's took food in a completely different way as well, more science cooking now.
And obviously using Ultratex and these other ingredients, it's even filtering down to, you know, kitchens in the Lake District,
I mean, the good thing about like the molecular stuff is that, you know, it's taking food in a different way. And you know, there's all these top chefs are using it. I mean, I use it, but I don't use it to the point where like they use it. You know, I got the Ultratex out. I use it to thicken my coolies, or I can smear it onto a slip mat and make it into a fruit twill, you know, rather than actually making, you know, with the egg and the flour and putting the coolie through it, sort of thing. Just easier and it's quicker.
You're playing with things like veggie gel as well,
right? Yeah.
Sure. Well, it's been great to catch up with you. Obviously, we'll see you again in November. I'm going to invite you down and see whether you have all the winners this year.
Yeah.
Really important to really identify like top talent that's coming through in the UK. And although I'm based in the Lake District, it was quite fortuitous that you were as well.
Yeah.
And also worth mentioning that we discovered this morning that our ancestral homes are only a couple of hundred metres away from each other in Liverpool.
Pretty surprising.
Absolutely. So there's a good sort of commonality there
for
the future. But Eddie, it's been great to catch up with you, and congratulations once again.
Thank you.
And we'll see you again soon.
Cheers.
You take care.